So, in first session, we have learned firefighting. Basically, divided into two branch. What is the branch? Can anyone tell? Abdul, Harish.
Hydrant and the fire alarm.
Yeah, basically suppression and
Fire
fire detection.
suppression. Yeah.
Okay, suppression and detection. Abdul, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in suppression, what are the things over there? Sprinkler, hydrant, okay, extinguisher, FM 200, all those things comes under suppression. Detection, you have
Suppression.
fire alarm, public addressable, right?
Public system. Yeah.
So today we are discussing about the fire alarm. Fire alarm, basically, what is the use of fire alarm? So in before the fire starts, okay, actual fire into come into bigger version, okay, intensity if comes to more, okay, before that it will activate and it will give the alarm. Basically, it is used to give a warning, okay, to the building
Okay.
occupant.
Okay.
So if I draw 1 second. This is the stage of fire, different stages of fire. Okay.
Okay.
Here, this side is fire. And this side is time. Okay. And first stage. In first stage, there are basically four stage of fire. Okay, first stage, nothing is visible. Okay, nothing is visible. Still, we can get an alarm.
Okay.
That is called air sampling method. Air
sampling
method, or VESDA, we will tell. Very early smoke detector apparatus.
Okay. Okay.
Second is your smoke will be there, visible. Now it is visible. And it will be smoke is visible, right? So here it will be addressed by detectors, smoke detectors. Third
okay.
stage is little bit more flame will come. So it will be flame detectors.
Okay.
At last, it is very intense. By the time it increases, you see the fire also increase. So intense fire here. So intense fire, what will happen? Which can be addressed by your sprinkler, hydrant, and all those things. Okay.
Okay.
So same thing. So here you can see different stages of fire as we discussed, fire intensity and with respect to time.
Okay.
So here invisible, we are having air sampling detectors, or it is called VESDA. Second is visible
VESDA.
Smoke, which will be catered by your smoke detector. Third is your flame fire.
Okay.
Fire flame. Stage four is intense fire. You have sprinkler activation system.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Basically, fire alarm is used to design. Fire alarm is designed to warn the occupant, okay, or owner to convey the fire has happened. Okay, to convey the message basically. Second is what are the codes and standard we will follow for designing fire alarm.
Okay.
So these are the basically four codes we will follow. Code in the sense two code are there. Okay. NFPA codes. And top two are with respect to the product. Okay. We should use UL product or EN54 products. Okay. And it should be LBCP. Okay. Loss prevention certificate board.
Okay.
It should be certified with that product.
Okay.
And NFPA 72 fire alarm code, you know, as usual, 70 is electrical code. These are the two codes we will follow for designing.
Okay. Okay.
Now these are the advantages. We know what is the advantage of fire alarm. So what is the advantage of fire alarm? First of all, it is necessary as per the legislature. Okay. If you're building your house, if it is up to certain height, beyond certain height, you need to implement, you need to install Firealarm. Okay, that is one part. Second is it will warn the building occupant, okay, before the actual fire occurs. It is very life saving, as you know, because it give an alarm so people get alert and they can evacuate and they can take the primitive measures. Fourth is you should maintain the fire alarm everywhere. Every maintenance and all you need to do periodically. Maintenance you need to do. Generally, what happen? People thinks there is no fire, right? We don't know whenever fire will happen. Once in a blue moon, fire may happen. But we should maintain our system such a way that in case of fire, it may activate. Okay. We don't know. We have done the construction in 2000. Okay. In 2020 or 2030, fire will happen. We don't know. But periodically maintenance, we should do it.
System should be in working condition.
Yeah, yeah. It should be in working condition. Properly, it should work. Okay. Those are the major points with respect to the fire alarm. Next, this is the overview of the fire alarm system. Okay. Here you have, this is your control panel. This is a control panel. From there, it goes to the detectors. These all are detectors. Okay. And you have MCB and hooters. Okay. From there, it will be returning back.
Okay.
So now, before going further, what?